Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 2. I just slept here in the Grafe's inn. I was going to do the whole thing off screen, but then once we were finished with our rest, this popped up. You awaken and hear someone stirring, growling. Looking over, you see Maneha, still not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, twitching and muttering in her sleep. You can't make out what she's saying, but from her bared teeth and the sheen of sweat on her brow, this seems like a very bad dream. Let's not shake her. She might hit us. Wake up, Maneha. She sits bolt upright, roaring and reaching for her weapon. We can deck her. Calm down. You're safe.
Whatever. Oh.
Her gaze darts around, but slowly focuses on you. She grimaces and looks away, wiping her face.
Oh, sorry. I must have been dreaming.
She lies back down and turns away from you. There's something in her past haunting her, that's for sure. Perception check. You can't help but notice how carefully she's avoiding your gaze. About what?
No, it's nothing. Sorry, I shouldn't have bothered you.
She pulls her blanket over her shoulders. You aren't bothering me, but something's clearly bothering you. I'd like to help. She's quiet for a long time. It seems like she's already gone back to sleep, but then she sighs.
You told me about your awakening.
Aloth stirs. Maneha waits silently until Aloth rolls over and resumes sleep. Deep, steady breaths.
I guess I've had a similar problem.
Really?
There's something I remember from a former life. Happened hundreds of years ago, but I remember it like it was yesterday.
How did you remember it?
Happened while I was fighting in Old Velia 20 years ago. My unit was camped out in the palace we'd just taken. The others were roasting the last of the Marchesso's pigs in the feast hall. So I went to the wine cellars to fetch a few bottles.
She works her fingers into a knot. This is interesting. I didn't think we'd find out the truth of what's going on with her, you know, for quite a while.
I don't know how long she'd been hiding there, but there was this old woman. Must have been one of the servants.
Her fingers curl into fists.
She had this wild look in her eyes. I approached her and tried to tell her not to be afraid, that she was safe.
Maneha holds out her hand, reliving the memory.
She screamed and grabbed my arm.
She closes her eyes.
It felt like someone had hit me in the back of my head. I blacked out for a few minutes, and when I came to, she was gone.
Go on.
I took a few bottles up with me, feasted with the rest of the troops. But when I went to bunk, I had a dream.
She shivers.
Only it was more vivid than any dream I've ever had. I tasted the sweat on my lips, felt the jungle air on my skin. Heard the cries.
She stops and swallows, shaking her head. What about the old woman?
I asked the other troops. None of them had seen her. Anyway, I laid off the drink for several days, but I kept having the dream. After a few weeks, I thought a change of scenery might do me good. Since then, I've been a pirate in the Deadfire, a pilgrim in the White That Wends, an adventurer in the Living Lands, and a gift bearer in Ishamadal.
Ishamadal. Ishamadal, right? That's a tough name there. She gives you a rueful smile. What's this memory?
It's something terrible I did. A long time ago. And as a different person. But I remember it more clearly than anything.
So I guess that's not coming out yet. What next, then?
I told you I was looking for the Abbey of the Fallen Moon so I could leave something behind.
Right.
There's a pool there, the Salt Well. It's where gift bearers leave the heaviest burdens.
She pauses.
It's said that a person can enter it and leave their own memories behind.
Really? There's a distant, hungry look in her eyes, so she desperately wants to forget something. And you would leave this haunting memory in the Salt Well.
That's the plan.
What if you lose more than you intend?
At this point, I'd gladly give up all my memories if that's what it takes for peace in this life and the next.
I want to ask you about something. Tell me why you really became a gift bearer. I heard about the order from some missionaries while I was in the Living Lands. I'd heard Andra's doctrine before, but the way they talked about the peace of forgetting, washing the old away with the tide, it sounded good. And gift bearers' work, taking to the road, helping people lose their own burdens, that sounded good too. Kept hoping I'd find a way for me to lose my burden along the way. That's all for now. A pretty song. Maneha confessed that she's seeking the Abbey to dispose of her own painful memory. The Abbey has a well in which the faithful can cleanse themselves of their pasts. If that's her, she's singing in another language. Wait. I'm picking it out now. Interesting. We didn't hear this at all until now. Alright, see you guys at the mine. Okay, we're here. Oh, we need to keep to the right-hand side or something and watch out for spiders. Crystal Eater. Oh, goody. And a moon spiderling. I don't want to go all out with this against two enemies, right? Concussive missiles. Scratch two spiders. A spider venom sack and a spear spider leg.
Got it.
The other one doesn't have anything. Okay. So far so good. No searchable stuff. Oh, here's another one. They die pretty quickly. Let's just... there's more, though. Alright, fireball.
Hmm.
soul ignition? Why not? Blessing again? Oh, there's more over there. Are we stuck in webs or something? I'm making short work of these things. All the legs. And Saks.
Got it.
Saks Fifth Avenue. All right. Oh, there's another one. You know, we're just about to move on and... never mind. We are doing fine.
Sure.
Show. And I mean show. Let's just check the these tunnels. Be thorough and everything. Ah. Must kill all spiders. Ooh, what's that guy? He looks rather colorful. Alright, we're kind of like in a... stuck in here. Can I dare move over here?
Hey.
And then go like this?
Hey.
Nope! Alright, I don't want to be... Palagina be doing all the work. Can Aeloth reach back here? He can't see. There you go. Yay, we can reach him, or most of us can. Can we go that way? Nope. We're
no
running all the way around into danger. That's no good. What is this? Oh, cool. A pike. Padded armor. Oh, we'll just take the money. Love the music in this game. This is back where we came in. Wait, that's another tunnel? Wait. Did I miss something? Looks like we can get there from across here. Oh, we can't. That strange heavy odor of sweat and sulfur wafts up from somewhere below. Well, we've been here. You know, I tried clicking on this winch too to see if we can, like, lower ourselves down. Wait, we can see way down there. Okay. These mines are a lot bigger than I originally thought. This is going to be a little short side quest type thing. Oh, we left some goodies over here. You don't want to miss any spider legs or sacks or anything like that. That would be no good. Here we go. Alright. Oh, this... Can you come with us? Okay. And I can't select that to make it come, so I guess it's just gonna stay there. Unfortunately. Continuing. Oh, we have stuff to look at. A peek inside these shallow burrows reveals the gleaming stare of many eyes. Yes, come out and we will kill you. Something big is probably in here. Can I save? Save completed, okay. Oh, maybe not. I'm sure something's coming up, though. Oh. Oh, a rotting flesh construct. Beautiful. Does it attack? Oh, there's that Cillan that we heard about. Oh my. Please don't attack us with these things. Hey there! Hang on just a moment. She turns towards the nearby constructs. How do you guys survive the spiders? Stand down! The constructs stop instantly, limbs going limp at their sides. There we are. Now what can I do for you? You control these constructs? That's right. Pretty solid workers, seeing as they don't eat, sleep, or go crazy and kill their workmates. She smirks. Not as often as your usual miner, anyway. I'm looking into the disappearance of the miners for Ismi. Can you answer some questions? Suppose so. Not sure how much help I'm going to be. Tarek's the one that found Gamel. Do you think Gamel's responsible? Sure looks that way, seeing he's got bits of Samoth in his teeth, she grimaces. Have you noticed any strange behavior in the other miners? Mining's rough work at the best of times. It's why I like using the constructs. I think these tunnels just start to get to people over time. Never thought Gamel would snap like that, but sometimes, yeah, folks start acting a little strange. Like when, who was it? She frowns. Huh. You know, my memory's been acting up lately. I'm starting to think Tarek might be onto something with that gas theory of his. Well, farewell. Swing on by if you have any more. Cillian's gaze seems to slide off you. With a sudden convulsive ripple, her posture changes. She hunches forward and her arms dangle loosely at her sides. Oh, you're possessed, and you're going to tell all these things to kill us. Brothers! Sisters! Terranat is here! Her head turns toward you, but her gaze is empty. Terranat? What are you talking about? We've been looking for you. We know what you've done. Her legs trudge forward in slow, ponderous steps, as if she might collapse under her own weight at any moment. There's an unnatural cadence to Cillan's voice, almost as if she were reading lines. But you sense something more. There's another presence here, twined about her soul essence like webbing. Take him away. Lock him up until we get what we want. The constructs behind her turn as one, their clawed fingers at the ready. Let us seek out the foreign presence in Cillan's mind. Time seems to slow as you extend your cipher's senses to probe the snarl of soul essence coiled around Cillan's own fainter life energy. You have the sensation of being watched, pinned under the hostile gaze of a dozen eyes. A dozen eyes? Are the spiders controlling this? The presence tightens its grip in a desperate bid to regain control, and you feel your own senses falter. Despite your best efforts, your connection is severed. Oh, damn it. The constructs charge towards you. Yep. All right. At least we got our fighters in front. Palagina. Flaming sword thing. Knockdown. Bloop. His knockdown is per encounter. Neat. I was afraid it was per day. Who do we have here? Mineha? I have to remember how to do her, Wait, she's a barbarian. Right, I had her confused with a chanter. She's not a chanter. She's a barbarian. Never mind. Because the one Omawa we had before, he was a male. I forgot his name. Kanna. And he was a chanter. That's what got me confused. She's not. She's just a fellow Omawa of his. She's just very... She gets damaged very easily. Barbaric blow. Here, I'm thinking. Wait for combat, and then I'll do Holy Radiance. In case you guys can't tell, I love Fireball. No, let me wait for him to get in effect before I do that. Bounding Missile. And Soul Ignition. Alright, now... Well, the combat has begun. Yeah, Holy Radiance, we're gonna leave the area of effect, unfortunately. How about, Pillar of Holy Fire? Here. Next Flame of Destruction there. That actually will get all of us, so we'll use Holy Radiance. I'm not sure if wounding helps against constructs. She's still in the middle of using her spell, isn't she? Well, I can go in with the fireball now. Not harming Palagina. Knock him down again. Blessing. Concussive missile. She's still... She can use these things. Here on this guy. You can't use it? One down! Sworn enemy. Oh, he got knocked down as well. This fireball would be good right now. I could get all three of these. Well, I don't want to hurt him. Damn, we're all getting knocked down. Healing time. I can't reach us both.
Hmm.
One more time, knockdown. Could use another area effect spell. Roll out of these. Supposed to be enemy only.
Yes.
Endurance, That looks cool. Cleansing flame. Oh boy. Some healing time here. Palagina and Maneha. And she's got this ring. I don't see the option for it though. Second wind, plus 69 endurance. Knock him prone again. Lay hands. That's per encounter. That works. All these guys can be frightened, but Cillan can. Barbaric shout. Oh, you're not even doing anything. You're a death, nice. Wounding. Alright everyone, pile on this one. Cillan, the overseer of the sulfur mining operation, ordered her constructs to attack me. I was forced to kill her. Wow. Vessel flesh. Yeah, it was kind of a tough battle. A yellow-tinged vapor gusts occasionally from these vents, leaving an acrid odor in the air.
No problem.
Oh, are we supposed to go through there? Let's see what's on her. Exceptional rod. Cool. Exceptional breastplate. Nice. Looped rope. Huh. Glance clarity. What is clarity? Plus 20 defense against blinded, weakened, unconscious, terrified, stunned, stuck, sickened, distracted, prone, petrified, paralyzed, hobbled, frightened, dominated, dazed, confused, and charmed attacks. That's nice. We're keeping that. A young knight sought a legendary armorer beneath the mountains of the Living Lands. The knight brought a fortune in gold and asked the armorer to craft something exquisite to protect her on her adventures. The old armor agreed on the condition that the young knight would apprentice with him for 3 years to learn the basics of his trade. The young knight agreed and worked at the armorer's side day and night, fashioning breastplates, greaves, cuisses, and shields. That's a new one. For me, anyway. As the third year drew to a close, she wanted to see what marvelous piece the armor would craft for her, yet the old man never picked up a hammer but to correct her technique. On the final evening of her apprenticeship, she approached the armorer and asked about the reward he had promised. He counseled patience and told her he would finish it by morning. When she arose the next day, she found him sitting by the hearth, twisting a length of rope. "I've done all you asked," she said. "I've served you faithfully and learned your trade. Where is the armor you promised me?" "It is here," the old man said, holding up the rope. "You vowed to grant me a great protection," the knight said, her hand moving to her blade. "And so I have. You have worked at my side for 3 years. You have seen how even the strongest steel shatters, dents, and rusts. The greatest protection is not bent metal, but mastery over your own mind. With this, even the gravest wounds shall not stop you." Wounds. Alright. We'll take that, thank you. Scroll of Prayer Against Treachery. Galvanizes the devotion of the party, granting immunity to the charmed and dominated afflictions. For 28 seconds. Cool. What about this way? Is that a dead end? I don't want to go in there yet. This dark burrow extends deep into the wall of the mines. Unlike the miners' tunnels, the walls here have an almost slick texture, interspersed with damp, pressed earth. A few paces past the entrance, the tunnel widens considerably. I didn't want to go in there yet. We have an option to go back. I was just curious about it. You find yourself at a crossroads where the tunnel splits off in three directions. Two tunnels lead to the left and right, while the third stretches on ahead of you. You feel a breeze, faint but steady, coming from the tunnel to your right. Retrace your steps to the exit. You trace your steps and make your way back to the exit. Alright, because, yeah, I want to see what's that way. And who could use this belt? What are we using for belts here? That's a bracers. Regeneration. And I have this to per rest. Was supposed to be able to use it in combat. It's supposed to show up over here. And it's not there. Oh, that's it. It's under here. Okay. Galvino's Resonance Amplifier. All right.
Got it. Sure. Right,
let's look this way. Actually, I wanted to switch this belt. That's a pretty neat belt. Like, a lot of, yeah, that's pretty good. Plus 20 for all those things. Only, who the hell has it? We have so much crap. All these traps I don't even use. You know what? I don't use them and they're just taking up a room, so... If I need to use them, they're there. Something you set up ahead of time anyway. Here's the belt. No. That's Girdle of Mortal Protection. I'm actually going to sell that. This actually helps. It's a good buff before battles. Plus 45 max endurance, plus 3 might, and resolve. For 150 seconds, so 2.5 minutes. Bracers of Spiritual Power. 10% spell damage. This is stuff I considered using at one point. Oh yeah. Do I want to be using this? I don't even know. It's stuff I haven't, like, decided on. There's a scroll. For all I know, I'm looking right at it. No, it's right here. Looped rope. Yeah, good. We switched it. So now I have 20%. Defense against all this stuff. Pretty sweet. Yeah, I wanted to see what's here. There's a dead person here. Oh, and there's more tunnels.